I mean, she's competitive in all aspects of life, in soccer, in school, in euchre, basically anything. And it's a good thing because she's not competitive to a fault. She's competitive to a point where it's still fun and you can still enjoy it. It's not something that she goes crazy about. On the field, she's fucking quick. Go to her feet, obviously an amazing player, but she also is just energetic as hell. She brings energy with her wherever she goes, but on the field especially.
I thought her foot skills were amazing. She always could just do like quick little touches around a player and nobody could figure out how to defend her. She was so crafty and speedy, and I immediately thought she was going to be a great competition to play against and play with.
Her work rate and her work ethic are what made her a special player. The skill piece, some people have that, not a lot of people, but there's a bunch of other people that have had that same skill set, but they didn't have the same drive and the same desire and the same willingness to compete. She wanted to compete for everything. As a coach, I felt like I had to be more prepared. I had to challenge her more because she wanted that, and she brought that out of other players as well.
She has it in her from the beginning. She wants to score from the beginning. Like UTCS, the RMAC final, we scored within the first or second minute, and that was because of her hard work. You know, all I had to do was come and tap the ball in. But she did the hard work and she put out the heart and the passion onto the field and wanted to beat them that bad that she did it within the first 2 minutes. Like, that's a great player to me.
She was three and I took her to, it was an indoor facility, and that was like, of course I was, you know, kicking the ball around her with at home and throwing it at her, but I think she was three the very first time, because I remember it was hard to find, you know, the shin guards went up to the knee, her knee, and it was just hard to, because she was so little, to find the things to, or find her equipment to fit. It was the little bunch ball when she first started at U4. She was, you know, it was a little mosquito, swarm of mosquitoes. Other coaches have always told me, wow, your daughter and the ball, she's like a magnet, and that the ball is metal and it's just always on her foot and she doesn't even have to look down at it. It just became so natural. We spent a lot of time on trapping the ball. I mean, that was our big thing at that age. You just gotta learn to control the ball. You can't teach them passing or dribbling until they get a hold of the ball. And so we did a lot of trapping, and she would trap it, it'd be right there. And a lot of the players on my team, they were really good at trapping the ball. Kaylee was killing teams at that age, and double digits. Once we got to double digits, I was like, well, then I didn't need Kaylee or Harley to be in there. I could let play, you know, the other players that weren't as strong, because otherwise, you know, you got to let up a little bit.
So you guys ready for the game tomorrow?
Yeah. I'm going to be goalie.
Really? You guys want to announce your names for the record?
I am Jade. He is Harley. And she is Kaylee.
Ah, nice.
No, she's Kaylee.
Kaylee was definitely my best friend for a very long time. We were super close. We got along very well all the time. We got along on the field. I think we were two very similar players. We had sleepovers all the time. I remember having so many of them. But yeah, we had a good relationship. We were super close for a very long time. Kaylee brought kind of everything. She brought like hustle, she had good touches, she was a good passer, she was a good defender, good shooter. She was all around just a great player, and her energy, she always brought a lot of energy. I remember her being positive a lot. She was never really negative about anything. And like I said, I think we were very similar players, and we just connected well. We just felt like we kind of knew where each other was at, like on the field all the time, even if we didn't, but it looked like it.
She talked to me first for sure, because I was a little bit shy. And then me, her, and Harley all just kind of clicked together. We would always go out to eat together. We were together every single day. So I love her. She just controls the whole field. She's the best at her first touches, at her accurate shots. I love playing with Kaylee. We always just got each other on the field with our give and goes or our through passes. We kind of knew exactly how each other played without even saying it out loud. So it was the best playing with her, for sure. Yeah, we kind of just knew exactly what we were thinking or feeling or exactly where we wanted the pass. And that's kind of how our friendship is too. We know exactly when something's wrong, even when we won't admit that something's wrong, we kind of just get each other.
I think that she was super technical when we were little. Like she was really good at finding little 1-2s and changing speed and being like quick on the ball, finding ways out of like sticky situations, whereas like I was never like that like quick on the ball, or like I could never like get out of those tight little like corners that she could. I think like that really like set her apart from like other people. She like knew where like to go with it at a really young age, which was really cool. I think KK was definitely one of like the leaders on our team even when we were little. We always wanted to win, and luckily we did like a lot because of KK, and like she always worked so hard. Like I do really like remember that about her. Like she was always like the hardest working person on the field and always like found a way to like make a play or to do like something to help us to win.
I think the first time I met her was Rocky Mountain when Abby took me, the indoor place. She seemed nice. I mean, I think Amy and stuff were there and they like scared me, but I never really talked to KK that much at first, but she's obviously very technical. She just reads the field very well and can find passes easily.
Being together all the time and going to tournaments and everything, it was so fun. We all got along so well. I don't ever remember us like arguing or anything like that ever. And then it helped that the parents got along so well. The parents were all good friends. I just remember being together all the time. Like all we did was play soccer together or have sleepovers together, go eat together. It was awesome. It was so much fun.
I think going to Vail, when we would stay in the hotels together, we would sneak out of the room and run around the hotel and get yelled at by the front desk. It was super fun traveling with her. It's always fun traveling with your best friend, especially when you play sports together. That was probably going to Vail, because we would go every summer, so it was kind of a routine to just get in trouble at the hotel together.
I like always, when I think of like our 3v3 like tournaments, I always like go back to Florida. Like Florida was like just like the best time ever, and like I don't know why I specifically remember having like those little like frozen lemonade things, and like we'd eat those frozen lemonades together, and we'd have those I can't remember what they like the rags we would like dip in the cold water, and we'd like wring them out like over each other and stuff. I actually remember like Florida was literally one of the best trips like of my whole life. Like it was so much fun, and like with her and Jade and Amy and like everybody, it was just like so much fun. I think that's really cool that we won like so young. I think that's kind of, like you said, like it's really rare to like win a national championship, and like especially like a 3v3 like huge tournament like that. And I know like it goes on like every year, so it's like a really established like tournament. I definitely think that just like went along with like our like winning culture, like with the Rockets. Like we did really, really well, and I think like we not expected to win, but that was our goal, was to win, and I think like everybody was bought into it.
I think when Kaylee and I became like good friends, like best friends, was when I moved to Dave's team my junior year of high school, KK senior year, and we hung out all the time, went to Chipotle many times, Qdoba, did a lot of eating out, went to a lot of parties, but yeah, we were like best friends then.
She was this very confident, but little, tiny, skinny little girl that was confident that the questions were, would you take a freshman on varsity? And that told me right there she was pretty confident in herself. And I said, if she's good enough, absolutely. And I said, who are you referring to? And she said, myself. I said, if you're good enough, absolutely. So I could just see his confidence coming out of her and the drive. She wanted that before she ever got there, that to be a freshman starter or a four-year starter. I think it put a little bit of a chip on her shoulder as far as people could tell her you're too small. You know, you're now going to play with kids that are seniors, you know, could be 4.5, 5 years older than she was. But I think she just always had the attitude that she can do and that she can prove anybody wrong. And if you tell her she can't do something, she's going to go that much harder to do it.
I remember her being very... I just remember her being very in shape. Like, she would run all over the place, and she was very competitive. She always wanted to win. I remember practices even. She just always wanted to win and be on the winning team. Just, that was a really fun mid because there were great players to work with, and like, I miss that mid because I don't experience that in college. Like, I miss players like KK and Kylie to work with and get assists and goals off of.
She's always running. I think if we had the trackers on us, I think Kaylee would probably have like the highest amount of like distance ran like, throughout the game, or even probably in practice, just because she's so hardworking. Like, she knows that if she is running and like trying to get the ball, that she's going to make an impact. And especially when there's like not always like a lot of other people that are like willing to like take that extra step, like she's there and like she's going to do it. And that's all the time. I think she has more skill than a lot of people, but that isn't like, I know it's like partially natural, but partially because she works really hard, and also she is extremely driven. So how I was saying, she's like the same energy on and off the field. When she's on the field, she just wants to win and like be better than everybody else.
Plays with a certain energy that nobody else has, and that's beyond fitness. That's just one of those players, when you put her on the field, it just brings up the energy of the whole team, and just, she's someone that you want to play with because of that.
I love playing with Kaylee at the same time on the field. We always talk about that. I think we really read off of each other's runs very well. She has such a great vision of the field that she can predict my runs and I can predict hers. And I love playing her through balls or to her feet and can combine around players. I think that's how we really work well against defenders, is like combining around them and getting forward. She puts her body on the line. If there were stats to show how many goals were scored off of fouls, Kaylee is the one who caused those fouls. She takes the players on and defenders don't know what to do other than pushing her over and getting us a call. She helps drastically in helping us get forward and creating opportunities.
I remember my sophomore year, my sister like fouled her in the box and got a PK. KK got Legacy a PK and they scored.
We had a quarterfinal or a regional final game to get into the quarterfinals where we had to have a +3. She drew 4 penalty kicks in the same game. I mean, and it was different players fouling her. So had she retaliated, I think, or not retaliated, but had she got caught up in that, she wouldn't have had continued to draw those fouls. I think she enjoyed that. She got payback by that. Her message was always, I'll take care of it with the ball. I'm gonna beat you the next time, and you can foul me as hard as you want. Even sometimes when she would get a cross off and she would just get absolutely drilled, if we scored on the end of that cross, the pain was gone and she was okay with that. She didn't even remember the girl that hit her. It was about the end result.
Her attitude towards winning, there's no other way to describe it than she doesn't like losing. So if we win by one or we win by 17, like we did against one team, she's gonna have the same attitude. She wants to win, win, win. And if we lost, it was definitely rough on us. We hardly lost, and when we did, you know, she would be upset, I would be upset, the whole team would be upset, basically. So when we would win, it was like winning the World Cup after every win.
Oh, she always wants to win. Always. I mean, everybody does, but she wants it bad. Every last game, every last second. She just really wants it. She wants everything. So when she does fuck up, she kind of gets in her head a little bit sometimes and gets mad on herself. But I mean, that just shows her passion. She loves it. She loves to win, and she wants to do anything she can to make that happen.
She's been a baller since we were 12, and that was like the first time I met her. You know, she's always been able to go through people. Sometimes she'll start running, and I'm like, there's no way she comes out of this with the ball. And then she comes out of it with the ball. I'm like 30 feet down, and it's so mind-blowing to me. And I honestly tell that story all the time. I always tell the story of KK and how she's just able to keep it at her feet so gracefully that you honestly think that there's no way that she comes out of a tackle or something with a ball, and she does. It's amazing. So, I mean, KK completely, I think, elevated my game for me. She was a playmaker. She was dominant in the midfield, you know. She was strong, she was physical, and she was just packed into such a little body, you know? I think she really elevated all of the teams that we were on. She was a playmaker, she made everything happen for us. I wouldn't be half the player I am today, and I wouldn't have had half the goals I had in club soccer if it wasn't for KK. I mean, I think you could see our chemistry from a mile away. There was not a game, I think, where we didn't connect on a ball that no one really thought we would even think about. We just always kind of knew where each other were. You know, I kind of would know where she was going to run through, so I knew to run the opposite way. She knew that I was going to cut back at this exact moment, so if she, you know, slotted a ball through, she knew that if she waited too long, then she was going to have to hold it because I was going to be offsides, because I always was. You know, it was just complete chemistry between the two of us.
Outside to Lanning. Lanning misses it. Tries to get the ball back, but instead it's taken away. Now going the other way. Kennedy in transition. Kennedy looking. Now puts it into Garcia. Garcia's free! And it's a goal!
Fantastic, and that puts Broomfield right back in. You can't ask for a better ball than that. Let's see, let's go back and take a look here. As you can see, nice little slot of ball she's in. She's being held on by the next one. Touches it with her left foot, sees Martin coming out. What a goal, 2-2 ball game.
Great job by Kennedy.
Her ability on the ball, her confidence on the ball, her ability to go into tackles or into crowded areas and always come out with the ball on her foot one way or another. Strength, like she's super strong. She would get good with body, nice and low. She'd be playing with players that were sometimes 30 pounds heavier, you know, 7-8 inches taller, and never would she lose that physical battle because she had a good balance, low sense of gravity and good balance, and just her dribbling ability was the most impressive thing. Just she would take players on. She loved to take players on. Not like some people who take a player on just because they want to see themselves beat them. She did it with a purpose to get where she wanted to go, which was to the goal. I think that was the first thing that stood out to me. Just when you have a player that can break down defenses by dribbling, it opens up a whole nother problem for defenses.
So Dribble Quest, and they should put this in the dictionary, is when Kaylee took on 3 or more players and 1 dribble. So she would maneuver through all these players that you wouldn't think she'd maneuver through,
sometimes two players would clash. And it's just, it wasn't even about her, it was more about her getting it to the feet of someone who would, you know, score from 18 yards out or 20 yards out. But she was always assisting people. She was always making other players look good.
Go from like all the way from one end of the field, go all the way up, dribble past everybody, and like send like a perfect pass for anyone to score a goal.
The main thing I just remember is her literally getting by everyone through the team. She was always one I would look up and try and find her because she can literally dribble through the whole team. So whenever I got the ball, I always try to find KK first, but I loved playing with KK and I do miss it.
I definitely respected her a lot on the team. Playing with her on the field too, you know, you'd just sit there and watch this girl run with the ball, and it was so crazy because no matter what, she would, you know, run into players, but she'd still always come out the other side with the ball. And I don't know how she did it. She was just like a little snake through the legs, I swear. It was funny.
Sometimes she'd go, and nobody knew where it was going to end up, where she would end up. She had a purpose to get by one person, and then it was, well, I might as well keep going if I don't have a pass here. And so that would be her dribble, because she'd pick up a ball in the defensive third of the field, and she probably could dribble until she got to the goal, and then she was either laying it off or taking a shot. So that was her dribble quests. And they were fun to watch, because by the time she's done this once or twice, her players knew her. They were doubling, tripling her. So when she'd go into that, you'd be like, there's no way she's coming out. Or she comes out with the ball one way or another. Great balance, strength, like I said earlier, but those were her dribble quests that everybody, we would have a good time watching her go.
She obviously has a ton of speed. She just has a vision that I don't know if everybody else could say that they have. She knows who's going to be where and when she needs to like play the ball, or like if she needs to like take it in herself. I feel like she is pretty good at doing that kind of thing. Her different kinds of step overs and scissors, stuff like that, it tends to work pretty well just because like I know that she practices it. And like
she sees something, she knows exactly what she needs to do and exactly what she needs to accomplish in order to succeed in that game and in order to pull our team and get us the win. Her soccer IQ is everything, and she sees a lot of things on the field that a lot of people don't see, and that's what I admire about her.
Up to Kaylee Kennedy. Kennedy dribbling in the box, very close, in tight, and into the back of the net! Colorado School of Mines walks it off! A golden goal here in overtime as they beat St. Ed's by the score of 3-2. Kennedy had it in short. She sent it through a couple of different pairs of legs, and then
She's more of a giver with the ball than she is a taker. My biggest thing trying to coach her was to take more, to score more goals, because she would get herself in positions off the dribble or receiving a pass, because technically she could receive a difficult ball in traffic in the box, and she'd always look for another pass. So it was kind of the opposite. She would always give the ball away. It was kind of training her to score the goal yourself, because after you give it away a couple times and you set somebody else up for this easy goal, then they're going away from you and they're trying to take that pass away. Now you've got to read. Now that's your time to score the goal. And she actually enjoyed scoring goals when she, you know, when she, it took her a while to get to that, but her natural thing is to pass the ball. So for players, she made players like McKenna, like Sophia, anybody around her that played up top, she made them so much better because she'd put them in positions that it was just finishing. They didn't have to do much else than finish. She did most of the work. They'd have to be in position and finish. So she integrated well with all different types of players. Players that could finish, players that couldn't, because then she would know to get the ball back off of them. She'd get the ball, find them, and then find another space to get the ball back off of them, and then find somebody that maybe was stronger at finishing.
Kaylee was always a leader on the team, and she definitely lifted us up and always encouraged us to work our hardest and do our best. And it was inspiring watching her, even in practices, you know, running her drills. She was always just working as hard as she could. And you could tell that, you know, after club soccer, it wasn't stopping for Kaylee. She wanted to go farther. You know, of course, with her being one of the leaders on the team, you know, she has to get loud with us sometimes. But I swear, she would always come up and pat me on the back and be like, you know, you did a great job. It was a great half. Let's get back out there next half and do it again. She was always just so positive.
She definitely taught me a lot of things, like staying composed on the ball, just finding people's feet. But she also brought a lot of confidence in myself. You know, reflecting after every game when we went out to dinner or to lunch after every game, or spending all the time that we had out of state trips like in California. You know, she was always a player that gave you constructive feedback.
I feel like she was always inclusive. She always included me, and I just remember when I quit soccer, actually, she was the person to call me to bring me back to playing. So that was really cool, because now I'm in playing college soccer, so she really is the one who kind of started all again for me.
One thing I definitely remember was her showing up before her games with her Big Macs. It was so funny. I think it was like the second year she would show up and she could eat like a whole Big Mac before the game and then just go out there and kill it. That girl, I don't know how she did it. I'd throw up if I did that, but she would eat it and then she'd just go out there and play super, super good. Maybe I should have eaten a Big Mac before my games.
Most of our interactions are humorous. I mean, we like to have fun, we like to laugh about things. Even if we do have serious conversations, it's usually lighthearted in the end, just making jokes about stuff. And we can make jokes out of basically anything, which is great. We have a lot of fun no matter what we talk about. Even if it's something that's really sad, depressing, we find a way to make it fun and happy in the end.
I knew she was very free-spirited. Like, I could tell her absolutely anything and trust her with anything. If I needed to get something off my chest, Kaylee was the one I would talk to. I could trust her from the get-go.
The most dynamic player I've ever coached. And I've coached a lot of players. She's the most dynamic. She can do the most damage to defenses and to individual defenders on the ball than any player I've ever coached.